Well, you convince me, Paul. Competitive kite flying is just like when Roland's parachute didn't open over the Columbia Gorge.
Roland, did you know Paul is also into photography?
Really? I spent 5 years capturing the brutal conflict in the Sudan. What do you shoot?
Mostly babies coming out of produce. Check it out. I fit these triplets into a summer squash.
That is infinitely more disturbing than anything I've ever photographed.
Here you go, fellas. Two whiskeys and a light beer for Paul.
Actually, I ordered the light beer because I'm secretly a sorority pledge. But Paul, you should enjoy your bourbon that you definitely ordered.
It's actually a scotch, Jack. You can tell by the color. Looks like a Glenn McManus 18?
25. We're not on a spring break, but very keen eye, Paul. I didn't know you were a Scotchman.
My grandfather owned a distillery.
Well, what do you know? My grandfather drowned in the distillery.
Look at you two bonding over scotch. Nothing else.
I'll get another round in, shall I?
I really shouldn't have another drink, Jack. Plus, me and my bros signed up for a sunrise pottery class. Gotcha. It's just gonna be me.
Look, this is why you came out tonight. If you want to bond with Roland, you need to drink.
Don't think of it as peer pressure. It's just what you have to do to be liked.
I never thought it would happen to me, but there I was in the bathroom with two stewardesses. One of them grabs me by the shoulder. The other one pushes me against the wall and says, "Sir, please take your seat. You are having a panic attack."
Yes. I have a very similar story, but with a totally different ending. Has Brooke ever mentioned her half-brother, Vincenzo?
Good one. Next round's on me.
I'm beginning to understand what the kids mean when they say they like something ironically.
See? Not so bad.
Well, I suppose if I get drunk enough for the rest of my life, I could tolerate him.
Now you're talking like a father-in-law. Come on, let's get Brainy Smurf home. Where'd he go? Eddie, have you seen Paul?
This doesn't count. It's my cheat day.
I know Paul's not answering the phone, but is this really necessary?
Look, we'll both feel better knowing he got home. I'm sure he's in there doing typical drunken guy stuff, like poaching a chicken for tomorrow.
Dad? Dad? What's going on? Where's Paul?
That's a great question, and one which Jack will happily answer right now. We're up, kid.
Paul was getting cold during our bros night, and so we swung by to get his scarf.
No, that's not it at all. No, Paul specifically asked for his coat.
This is not how improv works.
You're wrong, Jack.
Well, this one's a bit heavy, but it should work. Wait, why didn't Paul come up to get his own coat?
That's a great question, which Roland will answer right now. Roland?
You're up, Jim.
We got Paul so drunk that he's wandering the streets of Chicago by himself.
It's funny because it's not true.
Well, clearly you're up to some shenanigans. I'm glad you're having a good time. But please don't actually let Paul drink too much, okay? His allergy medicine and alcohol do not mix well. Last month he had a glass of wine, blacked out, and signed up for 3 years of sunrise pottery classes. Thanks, Jack.
You're welcome. We lost Paul.